Hi everyone, World Team Championship, round 7, Italy against United States of America, Carlo Melzi against Petko Kostadinov. Carlo plays with black checkers on the bottom and Petko with white checkers on the top. They have just started. The position is something like equal. Now probably better for Carlo. The two teams have 4 wins and 2 losses, I think, for sure for Italy, but I think USA too. Double 5 for Carlo. I think he'll make 2 points and 3 or 1, probably 1. Okay, sorry, but I have always some interruption. They were explaining me that the match has already started because they had to wait my okay, but okay, no problem. So, double, I think it's a strong double, and I would say a pass, but I would pass if I was Petko, but Petko plays much better than me, so maybe he has a different opinion, and in fact he takes 6-1, not the best roll for Carlo. Go down from the middle. Five, four, another point. Carlo goes on with his blitzing. Petko tries to run. And he's not it, so good news for him. Now it is Carlo that tries to safety his last runner. The 5 is not easy. Probably 7-1. Double 1, very good roll for Petko. I think that now Petko is favorite. Another not very good roll for Carlo. He has to kill 2 checkers on the 2 point and ace point. No, he needs a six to run away, otherwise I suspect that a redouble will come very soon, probably at the next roll. And I think it is a pass too. Two zero for Petko. A wonderful double two for Petko. 13-11, I think. Would play down from the midpoint. Now Petko is thinking about doubling. Maybe it is a bit early. 6-5, of course it, and yes, go to the 10 point. Okay, Carlo hits back. One five, double hit. Carlo hits back and saves from gammon. Oh, I'm sorry, not gammon, from cube. At least at the moment. Three four makes the best 3 points board, the so-called rack. And now I think it is a double for Petko. Even if he has three checkers back, I think that his structure is very good, with a good inner board. The golden point, and probably it is a pass because Carlo has a no structure and a checker on the bar. Okay, 3-0 for Petko. Good start for Petko. Very good double five. Five, three hits. Two, one, I think. Yes. No, two, four. Dances. Now it is dangerous for Carlo. One is not the best role for Petko. Another 6-1. And a double one that is not so interesting. Not very interesting. 5-4, at the last Carlo manages to re-enter and hit, but if he hits, he has not a good 5. Probably he has to hit on the 3 point. Otherwise, he can enter on the 5 point and cover the make the 9 point. But I think it's better to hit. Six one enters just with one checker. I would make the 4 points. Ah, no. Okay, this is better. Yes, of course. Six, four. I think I would make the 17 points and hit on the 3, or hit on the 3 from the midpoint. It is not an easy choice, at least for me. Carlo is thinking about a more structural move. Now it is looking at the most aggressive one. Very good double five for Petko. Yes, I think this is the best move. No very much choice, not too much choice. Too many choices, sorry. My English is far from perfect. No, I prefer Petko position because he has a good anchor that control all hold the outfield. And now I think it is ahead in the race, but I'm not so sure. Now it is a classic holding game. I would like to know the pip count. I think this is quite even. It was quite even. Now Carlo is a big favorite, and I think it will be a double next move, and probably a pass. Okay, it was just a matter of race, of pip count, and probably Petko was behind in the race for quite a bit, and so he passed. Now 3-1 for Petko. Five two. Butterfly anchor for Petko. Six to run. Five four, not so. Ah, okay. Five four, as Michi suggests, in the early part of the game from the butterfly anchor with a 4-5 or 6-3, usually it is a good choice to go to the midpoint. Carlo hits, but Petko hits back. Now Petko is ahead in the race. He has just one checker back, and Carlo has two. So he decided correctly, I think, to slot the 5 point. Another 5-4, so he can run with the last checker, which is straggler. 4-2 make the 4 point. Another 5-4. And probably he has to hit on the 4. Or this one is the safest one. 6-3, Carlo could make the bar point, the opponent's bar point, but probably is behind in a race, and so he prefer to stay back to control white checkers better. Now is another possibility to it, but nothing. He missed another shot. In the meanwhile, he's preparing his inner board. I think I would play from 6 to 5. Petko is thinking about doubling. Probably it is early. Because Carlo's board is very strong. Another double two. But it is a bit dangerous, the position, Carlo's position, because Petko has a strong board and Carlo has no anchor. So now Petko doubles. Petko is ahead in the race and has some strong treats. But it is dangerous for him to hit loose because Carlo's board is strong too. Carlo's board is stronger than Petko. But not having an anchor is a big risk, and Carlo passi. So 4-1 for Petko. I don't understand why the video is not fluid. I think we have some problems with the network. It is very, very bad. I am afraid that I'll have to go down to check what is happening. Yes, sorry, the quality is really bad. I'll try to do something. Please wait a moment. Okay, I hope now it is better. I read audio problems. Please let me know if the noises from the board disturbs the video. In that case, I can, of course, I can stop them. I made them less loud. I hope it is better, but please let me know. I think that now the video is more fluid. Sorry, but I am not near to the players. I have at the first floor. The players are playing at the ground floor. And the computer with the webcam is on the near of the board, of course. And I am streaming from the first floor. So sometimes I have to go to solve some problems. Ah, okay, Cristina. Before was mute because I went down, so I was not speaking and I muted the microphone. Okay, better to hear that everything is fine. If there is something wrong, write in the chat and I'll try to solve the problem as far as it's possible for me. So, 4-2 for Petko. Yes, I would like to try to run. No, Petko makes another choice. Five two yes and make the ace point. Of course, your remarks are very important for me to improve the situation. So now 5-3. Okay, makes the ace point. Very good double five for Carlo. That has some interesting choices. This one is trying to escape completely, but he leaves a double shot. Four two misses. Now Carlo position is very strong and he doubles. I think he is ahead in the race and has a lot of the better board and a lot of threats to the struggle to the struggler of Petko. So it seems to me a clear double. Thanks, Tiberio. Yes, I am working hard to try to do the best with what I have at my disposal. I don't know. I think I should pass in this position, but I am a bit, let's say, a bit conservative. So maybe Petko will take this cube. I really don't like the position. Okay. I am happy to see that Petko agrees with me. And please be patient with my English, but it is what can I do? Okay, 4-3 for Petko. Yes, the other possibility is to move the two runners, but this is good enough. Probably better. Another 4-3. I think it makes the 2 points and slots. Maybe. I would like to slot. Sorry for the webcam that moves, the video is not very stable, but I have to try to put the webcam on another table, because if players move the table, the webcam moves, and it's not very pleasant, I know. We'll try to fix it. This is a safer move than slotting the 5 points. But of course it offers less possibilities. Four, five. Probably down. Yes, it could make the deuce point, but I think it is better to keep the 4 prime. Double 2 is probably a market loser. 3-6, but probably it is too good now. Of course, Carlo will think about the cube, but I think I would roll at least once. There is also a blot in Petko on board. So I don't think it is so risky to try to play for the gammon, at least to see how the next dice. Carlo agrees and tries to play for the gammon. fans, and his choice has been good, has been gifted by the dice. 2-1. I think it is too good. Too many builders, very strong board. 5-4, of course, makes the deuce point. Or at least, of course, for me, but. Think that Petko can be very happy to have made the anchor. And now Carlo, of course, has the two runners to bring at home, and so prefers to cash. So for all, even score. Five away, five away. Very good anchor. Golden point for Petko. Six two. My first idea was to play 13-7 and hit from the six to the four. Petko is much. Plays much safer than me. 6-3 for me, it is the opponent bar point. Now we have a mutual holding game. Carlo has an anchor on his opponent bar point, and Petko has the golden point. Yes, about the camera and the vibration, maybe I can try with another arm for the camera, but I am not convinced it depends on the arm. Now I think that Petko is ahead in the race, but not by so much. And in this position, it is not clear if it is an advantage, because he'll have to leave his anchor before Carlo. And in fact, he's thinking about running because his own board is stronger than Carlo's own board, and so he can afford to leave two blots. Carlo, Mrs. I don't think it is a cube for Petko because he is ahead in the race, but the midpoint is not easy to be cleared without problems. For one, goes to the ace point, I think. Ah, it can make the ace point or slot it. Five, four, six, five. Six one, and now oh, 6-1, very very good roll for Petko. He can't play the six. Now he needs a double. Or otherwise, he has to hope that Carlo misses. Oh, the double, and now it is probably a double pass. Yes, double two, I don't think it is enough to take the cube. No, double pass. So 5-4 for Petko. Which is a good score. Because with a double gammon, Petko can win the match. Another double five for Petko. And a double five for Carlo too. Now Carlo managed to escape with the two runners. And if he makes some points, his position becomes very strong. For one, I think can make the 9 points or the bar point. I think the bar point is better. Ah, 4-2, sorry, not for one. Yes, the choice is between 4 points but leaving two blots or 9 points, which is less good than the 4 points, but leaves just one blot. And I would prefer this move, the move that Carlo made. Anchor and slot the 5 point. I think it's too early to cube, but this is a very good roll. Six one hit. Cube from Carlo. I don't know, I don't think I would have cubed, but probably it is correct. In fact, Petko thought about accepting 4-1. Okay, hit. Four six make the advanced point, but now is two of double four, but it's less good than it seems because it can't safety the straggler, it can't hit the Petko's straggler, so not so exciting move. Roll. Maybe could make the 4 points with three checkers and slot the 2 point, or make the four and the two, but I would prefer this one. Four one. I think Petko has to hit. Five, five and two. Hit and covers. Very nice roll for Carlo. Double two, dances. Now it is very dangerous position for Petko. 5-4 is not a good roll. I think the choice between okay, I had not seen that he could go there. 3-1. Double six. It has to leave a shot. Okay, I would play from the 11 to 5. No four. Now Carlo's position is very, very good. The problem is to leave the 9 point without leaving shots, and it is not so easy. 5-3, perfect. And from, I don't know, from 6 to 5 or take off a checker. I think that Carlo has some gammon chances too. 5-1. Probably from 6. Yes. Carlo has 8 minutes left. Petko, let's see, 7 and 20 seconds. Double three is not the best roll because the most important thing to do in this 3-point game for Carlo is to leave his 6 point. And the three is the best die. No, not the best, the worst. Sorry. I6-1 leaves a shot. Oh, Petko hits. Oh, Carlo re-enters immediately. 4-1, take. Yes, I would not made pick and pass, but try to cover the blot and to close the board. It closed the board. And now I think that Petko chances are close to to 80%. But I would have to calculate if it is better to double or not. Okay, now it doubles, and the take point for Carlo is, let's say, passes, goes 2 away, 5 away. So 2 away, 5 away, yes, something like 25%. I think he has not 25%, and I think he has to pass. I don't think he has 25% in this position. Carlo has the same idea, and I am not so sure that Petko had not a double, redouble the roll before. I would have needed to think a lot about it, but Petko, of course, knows the situation much better than me. So 7-4 for Petko, double 4 for Carlo. I am not so sure I would eat. Probably I would make the golden point and the 9 points. Yes, no, this is better, I agree. Six three, good roll for Petko. No, I think it is too early to cube. Six two, Carlo safety the straggler. Double three, very good. I think I would play from the 17 to the 10 point. I don't like this too much. But now we think it's a double and probably a pass, instantaneous pass for Petko. So now we are two away, four away, a critical score. Let's say who make the first move. Petko play the first move. 6-5. Yes, Casper had the same idea than mine. 16-10 and the cube. In the game before, in previous game. Okay, Petko tries to run. Carlo hits and probably next roll it is a double. Ok, corretto. It can be a take because I think the position is not so gammonish. But if Petko doesn't manage to escape with his runner, with his straggler, it can risk the gammon. So it is not a very easy choice. And in fact, Petko is thinking about it. It is an important choice, of course. And he passes. Yes, pass because of raise, says Casper, but I didn't count the the race, so maybe it was much better for Carlo. And in this case, Petko had no practical chances just to escape for a worst race. And so in this case, it's better to pass. Now he makes a very important anchor at the score. Okay, and 10 point. Yes, 11 pips down, says Casper. 11 are quite a lot in that position. So I am sure that Petko decision is correct. Six one, I think I would make the 4 point. Petko has two blots in his inner board, so it's not dangerous to leave a blot for Carlo. 5 3. Can leave the midpoint or play 8-6-8-2. Five four, 6-2-6-1. Two one. Wonderful roll for Petko. It is another mutual holding game. Yes, I think that Carlo has to escape because to run because he has no good 5-3. And Petko has two inner blots, 5-3. Of course he can hit, but it's dangerous. 4-3 is a bad roll, he can't escape. Double six is a winning roll. Yes, I think this is a double and pass. I think that the race advantage for Petko is too strong. Now, Crawford, one away, three away. Twenty-five percent chances, match-winning chances for Carlo. At this score, the gammon is not important. Of course, not for Petko, but for Carlo too. The important thing is to win the game. Now Petko position is very, very good, very solid. He has the golden point and a 4 prime. Six four, I think two down. Yes. Double two for Petko. Very good roll. Makes a 5 prime. Four two. Good roll for Carlo. And now it is not easy for Petko to leave his golden point. He's well ahead in the race, but the timing is questionable, let's say. He tries to run. Seven, five, seven, four for me. Very aggressive move by Carlo. 1-6. Two six double hit, but Carlo has 3 checkers that has to escape from the 5 prime, so it is very difficult. But Petko has do 2 checkers behind Carlos prime and 1 in the bar. Three two, I think that I would, yes, would make that anchor, and yes, that this one, exactly this one. Five one hit and plays from yes. It doesn't hit. I think he has to hit because if otherwise, he has timing problems if Petko anchors. Dances. Covers, and now he needs a 6 in a very short time. No 6. 5-1. Not good. I would prefer from 2-1. Six at Petko re-enters. 2-1. Oh. For Petko, it is easier to roll a six than from Carlo. And now Carlo position is very weak. He didn't roll the six. Let me check if I have some info about the result of other players. No, no info. Ok. Six one is interesting for Carlo, but Petko immediately hits. Double two. I think that Petko is very near to win the match. No six for Carlo. Four two is a very good roll for Petko. Double three is not so good. Now he could find some difficulties with his 7 point. Yes, I would run with that checker. I would go to the 10 point. I don't see too many options. Three one. Two one doesn't change a lot the position. Five three. I am not so sure this is a good choice. Carlo has two gaps and Petko only one. Four checkers off for Petko. Carlo needs two doubles. Here is one double. Or Petko may roll another two. Could be a problem. No, not another two. No, so. Absolutely, a double for Carlo is the only possibility left. No double, and Petko wins the match. I think it's a well-played match, interesting match till the end. I don't know the other results of Italy against United States. So I would close I was watching who took the dice, but they are on the board. I have to go to take them before they disappear. It happens. So I thank you for watching, and see you in a short time for another streaming when next round starts, and there will be commented by stream team with better English than mine, of course. And a special guest that I think will be Bakar Matikashvili, a very strong Georgian player. So don't miss next streaming. Thank you and goodbye.